Chapter 1 Lesson 5 Customizing the Start Menu and Taskbar Part 3. In this lesson, we will cover customizing the start menu to suit your preference, an overview of recent programs and recent documents in start menu, the power button options, pinning and unpinning items from start menu and taskbar, and enabling toolbars on taskbar. Hello friends and welcome again to our Windows 7 Essentials to Advanced Video Training series. In this chapter, we will cover that how you can customize the start menu according to your preferences. If you right-click on the Start Menu button and choose Properties, then you will be in the same taskbar and Start Menu properties, but this time, the default Focus tab will be Start Menu. Whereas, if you right-click on an empty area of the taskbar and choose Properties, then you may notice that the default tab is Taskbar. So, what is in the Start Menu properties? Here, you can customize the look and behavior of the start menu and the items available under it. Moreover, you can also customize that which item you want to have under the start menu and which item you don't. If I click on the start menu, you can see that the start menu has been separated into two partitions. In the one part of the start menu, you will have the search box, all programs, and a list of recent programs. In the other part, you will have the shutdown button along with other items like documents, pictures, music, games, and computer, and so on. So, from the start menu properties, we can customize which items we want to have on the start menu, and how they may appear under the start menu. Our first option under the start menu properties box is power button action, and the default behavior is shutdown. So, what shutdown actually means. Do remember that it is important to turn off your computer in proper manners after you have finished working with your computer. Not only to save electricity, but also to ensure that your data is secure and saved. Most of Windows 7 users complain that the new shutdown button is not as much better as compared to Windows XP. This is because clicking on this button once will immediately run the default behavior sets. That means, as the default behavior of the button is actually shut down, and you click on the button mistakenly, then Windows will immediately execute the shutdown command, and no confirmation box will appear. Whereas, in Windows XP, when you click on the shutdown button, you come up with a dialog box, that what you like to do. However, you can change the default button as suited to your requirements. For instance, you lock your system for security reasons several times a day, then you can change the default button to lock instead of shut down. To change the button, right-click on the start menu and choose properties. From the power button action menu, choose lock and press OK button. Now, if you click on the start button, then you will notice that the default shutdown button has changed into lock. Means, clicking on this button will now lock down your system instead of shut down, and if you want to run any other power action, then you can click on the alongside arrow for choices. So, you can execute a desired command, as required. Suppose, you use switch user command, many time in a day, then you set switch user, as a default power button action. In future videos, I will cover in details, that, what switch user, log off, lock, restart, sleep, and hibernate options are. In the privacy section, you have two options, which are checked by default. The first one is store and display recently opened programs in the start menu and store and display recently opened items in the start menu and the taskbar. First we talk about store and display recently opened programs in the start menu. You may have noticed that whenever you click on the start menu, you always have a list of programs. These are the shortcuts to those programs that you use most often from various locations. For instance, if I open the word pad from start menu, all programs, accessories, and the word pad. Then next time a shortcut of word pad will be available in start menu, so you do not have to open it again from that outlying location. This saves yours a lot of time in day-to-day tasks. If you uncheck this option, then Window will no longer create a shortcut list to your recently used programs, and that area will get empty. Before I tell you about the store and display recently opened items, in the Start menu, and the taskbar, let me remind you something from previous version of Windows. In Windows XP, there was an item in the Start menu, called My Recent Documents, which was enabled by default. This drop-down menu shows you a list of recently opened documents from various locations. However, by default, this option has been disabled in Windows 7. So let's first turn on the recent items, so you may better understand that what is store and display recently opened items, in the Start menu, and taskbar. To turn on recent items, go to Start menu properties, and click on Customize button. You will be presented with a variety of options. Make a check mark on Recent Items, and finalize the changes by pressing OK button twice. Now, if you click on the Start menu, you have another option available, called Recent Items. So, what is Recent Items all about? Recent Items provide you quick access to your documents that you have opened recently. For instance, I am going to open one of my documents from Documents folder. The next time, when I need to open the same document and I do not have to move to the same location to open the document, the shortcut to the same document is also available under the Recent Items, and clicking on the name will open the same file from the original location. You can also customize the numbers of items in recent programs and recent documents do you want to appear. If you have a larger screen to work on, then you can increase the number of recent programs and recent items, so you have easy access to more programs and recent documents. You can also reduce the numbers if you have a smaller screen. To increase or decrease the number of items, open the Start menu properties, click on the Customize button, and change the settings under Start menu section. You can specify that how many numbers of recent programs to display in Start menu, and how many numbers of shortcuts of files to be appear in recent items. As I have changed both the numbers to 15. Now, when I will click on Start menu, I will have access to 15 most recent programs that I had used before and 15 most recent documents list in the recent items. So, it can save a lot of time and hassle with working with same files and programs. Do remember that shortcuts in the recent programs list and recent documents will change frequently as you open more programs and documents. Also, those are only shortcuts of programs and documents. If you clear the entire list completely, or even remove any program and document shortcut manually, then the original program or document will have no effect.
As you can see, in the right side of the Start menu, there are many items that are available by default after a fresh installation of Windows 7. You can also customize those items. You can configure that what option you need in the Start menu, and which options you don't. To configure it, go to Start menu properties and click the Customize button. Here you will find a very big list of items that you can configure to appear or remove from the Start menu. You can also configure that how those options should appear, either as a link or as a menu. We will discuss all the options in details in our future video, but for instance, let's change some options to know how they will react in Start menu. For instance, I am changing the Documents menu, which we had used in our previous video, to save our documents to appear as a menu. We will also turn on the Run command, which we will use in our next video. Further, we will turn off the Use Large Icon option for icons to appear smaller in the Start menu, and we will disable Context menus and Dragging and Dropping option to disable right-click option in Start menu. First of all, I am changing the Documents menu to appear as menu instead of a link. The effect of this will be that when you will move your mouse pointer near the documents in Start menu, all the documents will slightly appear alongside. So, choice is yours that how you want different items to be appear in your Start menu. If you have used previous version of Windows, like Windows XP, then you may have noticed that there was a Run command available in the Start menu, which has been disabled by default in Windows 7. We will turn on the run command so we may use it in our future references. We are also turning off use large icons options so you may have as much as possible space in start menu if you're using a smaller monitor. Lastly, we are disabling the context menus and dragging and dropping option from start menu and all its submenus. Before we uncheck this option, let's first see what is context menus and dragging and dropping exactly is. As this options is enabled by default, if in the start menu, you right click on any item, you are presented with different options. This is called the context menu. Also, if you hold the left click of your mouse on any item under start menu, you can drag them as to other locations, like desktop. However, these context menu commands are very useful, and we will also learn about many of them in our future videos, but for now, we are turning off the context menu. As you will disable this option, right-clicking on any item under start menu will have no effect and context menu will no longer appear, and also you will not be able to drag and drop any items. We will also talk about these two options in details later. You may now have a little overview of that how you can customize the taskbar and start menu according to your preferences. Now, we will talk about how you can enable toolbars on your taskbar to work more efficiently with Windows. As you move into the start menu or taskbar properties, you will also find a toolbars tab. You can use toolbars on the taskbar to work more comfortably. For instance, I am turning on the desktop toolbar. As you can see, I have a new option available in my taskbar, called Desktop. If I click on the arrow alongside with the toolbar, then I will have everything that is available on my desktop in my taskbar as well. This can be very much useful when I am working inside an application, and I need something to access from my desktop. Then I do not have minimize or close my current application, because what I need from my desktop is also available on my taskbar as well. Further, you can also add a new toolbar by clicking on New Toolbar option, and then you can choose the folder location you want to appear as a menu on your taskbar. For instance, I am choosing Documents menu as a toolbar to appear on my taskbar. So, now, I have access to all of my documents right from my taskbar. You can also choose your personal folders that we had created in our previous exercise. We will also talk about the other toolbars that are available by default, like address bar, links, and tablet PC in our references video.
As I described earlier that the recent program lists change frequently as you open other programs. So, if you want any program to access directly from start menu, instead of locating it from inside submenus, you can pin that program into your start menu or taskbar. For instance, you use Notepad most often, and you always have to access the Notepad through start menu, all programs, and accessories. Now, you can pin your favorite programs right into the start menu for easy access. However, pinning option was also available in Windows XP as well, but you can only pin items into start menu in Windows XP. Whereas, in Windows 7, when you right-click on any program icon, you have choice either to pin the program in start menu or taskbar, or you can pin in both, one by one. So, now, to pin Notepad into start menu, I will right-click on the program icon, and will click on Pin to Start Menu. Do note that, earlier in this video, we had disabled enabling context menus and dragging and dropping option. So to right-click on Notepad, first you need to enable this option. After clicking on Pin to Start Menu, you may notice that left side of the Start Menu has been divided into two partitions. Now, the pin programs are appearing on the top of recent programs. So, whenever you have any favorite program that you use most often, pin it to the start menu or taskbar. In our next video, we will customize the look and feel of our Windows 7 desktop. We will talk about themes, screensavers, wallpapers, color schemes, and much more in our next video. Till then, my name is Rajiv Kohli, and do subscribe to our channel for our coming videos on Windows 7.